Someone say, he's a great God. Hallelujah. Say, happy Sunday, everybody. Look at your neighbor and tell your neighbor, woo, today's the day the Lord has made. Today we're going to rejoice. Come on. Say, today we're going to be glad. Let's all stand. Say, we're going to rejoice and we're going to be glad in the name of Jesus. Come on. Hallelujah. Well, they're not like a day like Sunday. I like when Sunday comes up because, woo, I'm ready to praise the Lord. Come on. Are you ready to praise the Lord this morning? Are you ready to come before His presence with singing and thanksgiving? Come on. The Bible says in Psalm 66, make a joyful shout to God. Let me hear you say hallelujah. Hallelujah. One more time, a little louder. Hallelujah. Make a joyful shout to God, all the earth. Sing out the honor of His name. Make His praise glorious, says God. How awesome are your works! Through the greatness of your power, all the earth shall worship you, sing praises to you. They shall sing praises and they shall sing to your name. Come on. We're not here lifting up any other individual. We're here lifting up the name of Jesus. Jesus is His name. Somebody say Jesus. Say Jesus. Say Jesus. Now on Friday we're saying cowboys. Come on. I saw my little Belita. Come on, somebody. Now, we love our cow. We love everybody. But today, we're at church. Come on. We're not at a prep rally. We're at church. Come on, somebody. But at church, the Bible says, make a joyful noise. Come on, unto the Lord. So someone say, Jesus. Say it again. Say, Jesus. Lord, have your way in our service. Bless you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Come on. Here we go.
Oh, we bless you, Lord.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Come on, let's sing it. The Lord is my light. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. No, I will not fear. In times of trouble, He will keep me safe in His dwelling. He will set me high upon the rock.
Come on, sing it.
And my head will be exalted, high above my enemies. I will shout for joy and make music to my Lord.
Sing it, come on.
Hallelujah. 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 Let His people shout. Hallelujah. We sing hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let His people shout.
The Lord is my life.
The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. No, I will not fear. In times of troubles, He will keep me safe in His dwelling. He will set me high upon the rock. Rock, yeah. And my head will be exalted, high above my enemy. Shout for joy and make music to my Lord.
Come on, sing it.
Hallelujah. 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 Let His people shout. We sing, come. Hallelujah. 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 Let His people shout.
Oh, yeah.
Bless you, Lord.
Hey, yeah.
Come on, sing it. The Lord is my life. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. No, I will not fear. In times of troubles, He will keep me safe in His dwelling. He will get me high upon the rock. The rock, yeah. And my head will be exalted, high above my enemies. I will shout with joy and make music to my Lord. Sing it, church. I give you glory, glory, Jesus. Oh, we give you glory, glory, glory. I give you glory, glory, glory. I give you glory, glory, glory. Shout for joy and make music to my Lord. Lord, a praise offering. Oh, we serve an awesome God. Oh, we serve a great God, church. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Oh, we bless your mighty name, Father. We know that your love never fails, oh Lord. Nothing can separate. Even if I run away, your love never fails. I know I still make mistakes, but you and your mercies for me every day. Your love never fails. Oh no.
Sing it today.
You made all things work together for my good. You made all things work together for my good.
Oh, you're making all
you
things new.
All things work together for my good.
Oh, you're making, you made
all things work together for my good.
Oh, Lord, you're making
all things work together for my good. You stay the same through the ages. Your love never changes. There may be pain in the night, but joy comes in the morning. And when the oceans rage, I don't have to be afraid. Cause I know that you love me. Your love never fails. Oh, 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 oh.
Your love never fails.
Oh, 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 oh.
Your love never fails.
Hallelujah.
Who you
are. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Ooh, Lord.
He makes all things new, Lewis. Everything He makes new. Because His love never fails us. Father, we commit this day to you. We declare we have been saved and set free by the power, by the blood, in the name of Jesus. Can I have an amen? Just keep that going, Lewis. The month of October is very specific. And it comes from the book of Revelations, chapter 12. Starting with verse number 11. And they overcame. They overcame him by the blood of the Lamb, and by the word of their testimony. And they did not love their lives to the death. I'm declaring this month, October, is a month of the overflow. Come on. I'm declaring this month, October, is a month that we overcome. Hallelujah. The Bible gives us clear instructions. We overcome by the blood. Someone say the blood. We overcome by the blood of the Lord and by the word. Someone say, I have to say something. That's right. By the word of my testimony. Your testimony isn't what you've done in your past. Get out of your past, I say. Get out of your past. Come on, somebody. But talk about what God is doing today. Hallelujah. Talk about what God is going to do forever. Come on. They overcome him by the word of their testimony. And they do not love their lives into death. What does that mean? Get over yourself. Come on. Don't live just your life. Don't live just in love with who you are. But live for the Lord Jesus Christ. Live for him alone. And you shall overcome in the name of Jesus. Give the Lord a great hand clap. Hallelujah. This is living faith, not dead faith. Can I have an amen? You may be seated in the house. Praise team, please stay with us and stay standing at this time. But you are in a church that is full of faith. Someone say full of faith. A church full of love. Someone say full of love. And say a church with victory. Come on. That's our vision. That's our vision. The Bible says, make it plain. Come on. Make it plain. Three words: faith, love, and vision. So we breathe, we move, we speak faith, love, and victory. Hallelujah. And God specifically gave us instructions that we were to build the house of the Lord. So we are an apostolic ministry where we build. Come on, somebody. We build. Hallelujah. Who are we building? Disciples. Come on. Who else are we building? You know, families. Come on, somebody. Building men. Building women. Building children. Come on. Building entrepreneurs. Building ministers. Come on. Building businessmen. Building coaches. Come on. Building teachers. Building stay-home mamas. Come on. Building schools. Building our work areas. Come on. We are building. Someone say, we are building. It's done spiritually and it happens naturally. So we're an apostolic ministry, and that's what you stepped into right now. Thank you, Jesus. We are evangelical. What does that mean, Pastor? We love to evangelize. Come on. We got outreaches left, right, top, bottom. We got outreaches everywhere. Praise the Lord. And so we are an evangelical church where we reach out. If they don't come, we go to them. Come on, somebody. But as you can see, they come. Amen. Praise the Lord. And we continue to go as well. We had somebody come from New Mexico this morning. Hobbs, New Mexico. Someone say, when it's alive, it's worth the drive. Come on. Hobbs, New Mexico. We have a brother that's sitting here right now with the color green. He's from New Mexico. He's working in the oil industry, but he's here at church, and he's here to get a new oil. Come on, somebody. He came hungry for our first service, said, I'm going to stay for the second. Hallelujah. I'm going to talk about an overflow, someone say, double portion. Come on. Now, just know, when I said that, you should have been like this. Come on. Okay, let me rewind. Let me say it one more time. I'm going to declare this month, October, a month of the overflow. So I'm going to declare double portion. Come on. Receive in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of the testimony. And they did not love their lives to the death. Hallelujah. You see, to be a giver, you got to know how it is to give. Amen. God is a giver. And that's why he gave his son. So that we can come to the table of the Lord today. And we can commune. Ushers that are helping us this morning, please come. Praise team has already received the Lord's table. So I'm going to have the ushers direct their attention to the congregation. because I want y'all to just prophesy, sing, Lewis, and I want that same song, His Love Never Fails. But just that chorus that you play, you know, that or not the chorus, the bridge maybe, or what is it? Just something like that. But you're going to get it right. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So honored to be in the presence of the Lord. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Well, we're going to distribute the Lord's Supper to you. And we ask that you prayerfully receive and take as the Lord would lead you. Amen. So just receive as the praise team begins to sing, and then we'll have great words of faith here in just a few moments. Thank you, Jesus. Please start right now, and let's go ahead and begin to distribute. Have a full church. We have a full church. And so everyone will be receiving the Lord's table. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Work together for my
That's it right there, Lewis. Right there, you know. Yes.
You made all things work together for my good, Jesus. You made all things work together for my good.
Come on, just keep saying that. Hallelujah.
You made all things work together for my good. All things work together for my good. You're making things new, Lord. All things work together for my good. Yeah, yeah, you're making all things work together for my good. Yeah. Same through the ages, your love never changes. There may be pain in the night, but joy comes in the morning. And when the oceans rage, I don't have to be afraid, because I know that you love me. Your love never fails.
Because of the body, we are healed. And because of the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ, our sins are washed away. He gathered his disciples, Matthew 26, and he said to them, "Take, this is my body, and it is broken for you." He said, "Take, drink, this is my blood for the new covenant and for the remission of sin." And so, Lord, today, our first fruits of October 2016, We as a living faith body, remember, thank you, and honor you for your sacrifice. And because of your sacrifice, no longer are we separated from eternity. But because of salvation, I can speak and say, I am healed today. I can speak today and say, heaven is my home today. So with joy and confidence, I receive my healing in the name of Jesus. Please break now and eat. Oh, precious is the blood that washes my sin away, makes me as white as snow. Lord, we know that on that day your blood was shed. It was shed on the whipping post when they gave you 39 lashes on your back. It was shed when you walked with that cross to Golgotha and the crown was placed on your head and you bled, the Bible says. When they laid you on Mount Golgotha and pierced your hands, you bled. They pierced your feet, you bled. You hung on that cross, bleeding. At the moment you gave up the ghost, the Bible says you said, forgive them, for they know not what they do. And you looked up to heavens and said, receive my spirit, Father. And you breathed your last. Because man continues to doubt, they still try to pierce you. Because of the doubt of man, the Roman soldier pierced the 7th and 8th rib. And the Bible says that blood and water flew out. So we know that because of your blood, every drop was given for my salvation. You have been bought by the precious blood of the Lord. Please take drink. In the name of Jesus. Pass your cups to the nearest aisle at this time. Hallelujah and hallelujah. Just lift your hands and just say, Lord, I love you. Jesus, I love you.
Amazing grace.
Come on.
How sweet.
Some will remain seated. Some will stand. Some might even kneel. Some will lift their hands. Some will lift their voices. But let's all lift our hearts. Come on. By His grace. table. Someone say, thank you, Jesus. By His grace, we are saved. We're healed. And we're on our way to heaven. Hallelujah. Well, how you can, just do your best. Stretch out. Shake someone's hand right now where they are. Praise team, beautiful, anointed. Y'all may be seated at this time. I want all the students, the children who are going to class right now, I want you to come forward. Miss Kim's going to come also and prepare for a word of the Lord and some great October announcements. But I want all the students and kiddos to come, and students, because we're going to pray and learn the word of the Lord. Right, Frankie? Come on. Hallelujah. Awesome and awesome and awesome. It's great to have the Lord with our children. Come on. Can I have an amen? Right, Dosito? Come on. That's right. Everybody likes high fives. Some of y'all, man, y'all have a heavy hand. Thank you, Jesus. Wow. Man, mama and daddy feed y'all good. Well, thank you, Jesus. Okay, that's enough. Thank you, Jesus. Got to keep my hand to flip the Bible. Come on now. Thank you, Father. Well, let's lift our hands to heaven. Lord, I know these wonderful students are blessed. They're learning You, Lord. They're learning how to live for You. They're learning the full armor of God. They know they have the breastplate of? Let me hear you say it. You have the helmet of?
Salvation.
You have the belt of?
Truth.
You have the gospels of what?
Peace.
Come on. You have the shield of?
Faith.
And you have the sword of the? The war, the word, the spirit. Amen. Amen. They know it. Thank you, Jesus. We call them blessed in Jesus' name. Give Sister Anna a great hand clap. Amen. Give Lizzie a great, and all the teachers. All right, now you're soldiers. Remember, you're marching. So let me see one line. Hey, y'all, let me hear you march. Come on. Hut, two, three, four. Hut, come on, Dosito. Let me hear you. Hut, two, three, four. Give them a great hand clap. Amen. We love our students. Pastor Kim, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Pastor Mark. Well, we're excited because the church is growing and we have a new baby to add to our young, to our babies. I believe we have a picture. This is little Jeremiah Malachi Gonzalez. He was 8 pounds, 3 ounces, and he is beautiful. We got to spend some time yesterday with him, and he is white skin, powder white, and beautiful dark curly hair. He is so cute, and Denise was just excited, and we were there, and of course, you know me, always trying to take everybody's babies. So we were just so blessed, church, and I want you to be excited for them. She'll be coming home tomorrow, and you know, if you want to maybe take her some food or something, let me know. Because, you know, I really didn't realize how important Ministry of Hospitality is until I received that help. You know, when my sister came home and the baby was home, you know, and my house was a wreck when I always had a spotless clean house and everything was going on, and you know, I had so much going on, and then I'm thinking, gosh, you know, and I would get discouraged just looking around at everything, and here would come two beautiful ladies in bringing some food, you know, and I was like, wow, that's just one thing less I have to think about, you know. And Pastor Mark was happy, the kids were happy, Tiffers was eating, and you know, it really is a blessing. And you know, sometimes when you feel a little bit discouraged or you feel a little bit overwhelmed, a Sister Josie walks in your door and brings you a pot of lasagna. You know, you're like, Lord, I know You're with me. You're taking care of me. You know, everybody needs it. So, you know, if you want to help them out and give them a nice meal maybe sometime this week or next week, let us know so we can make sure we get it all organized. But it'll be a blessing to take care of our family. Amen. You know, it's, yes, amen. Let's give the Lord a great hand clap for all of our ladies that jump in and help. You know, this week was a big week, and it still is a big week, and I was just so happy when we were at the football game, and you know, we saw a lot of our young people represented there, and they were representing their school But you know, when I saw them out there, I saw them representing Jesus. You know, because these young people, the students had to vote for them and pick them. And when I saw them, I was like, you know why these young people were picked? They were picked because they represent Jesus. They represent character. They represent integrity. So I'm just happy to say that our king and our queen and our representatives this week were from Living Faith. So we're very proud of them. And, of course, they've got baseball going on today. But, you know, God is just so good to us. And we're believing, God, that the youth ministry is growing and the right people will help serve us. And they'll go and they won't turn back. Amen? Amen. You know, speaking of serving, we have a banquet coming up on October the 9th. And, you know, we know that this month is Pastor's Appreciation Month. And, you know, we appreciate everybody and wanting to honor us. But, you know, our heart is that everybody would be honored. Our heart, of course, is mainly that Jesus will be honored. Because, ultimately, this church would not be if it wasn't for the obedience of people. We were obedient by moving over here, but God sent people to be obedient and serve the vision, and God is doing great things. So on October the 9th, we want to celebrate everybody, and we're going to have a nice banquet. And you might say, well, I don't really serve in Ministry of Helps or anything like that. Well, you're here, and we want to celebrate you too. You know, it's for everybody. So some of the ladies, we don't really know all the details, and we know some, and the men have gotten together, and they're getting a meal together and table. So when y'all come on October the 9th, it's going to be set up a little different. We're going to have a banquet-style setting, and we're just going to celebrate family. We're going to celebrate what God has done, and everybody is welcome to be with us. And if you're here today, we absolutely want you to be with us every service you can. But this one is a special one, and we want y'all all to be with us. So be with us if you can, and that'll be great. And then one last announcement is this Friday, our football team has an away game. And we're blessed as a church. We're going to feed our football players and coaches. So, you know, we need a lot of food. So Linata's Barbecue is fixing up some good brisket for them. And we're going to serve and take care of our football players and coaches because we love our Cotulla Cowboys and Cowgirls. And if you want to come out and help, we'll have some more details later about times and all that. But if you want to come out and help serve our teenagers, y'all come out and be ready to help. And we're needing some desserts, correct, Pastor Mark? A lot of desserts. Yes. Sometimes he hides them in his office, too. Y'all know that. So, but we're blessed, church. Let me read y'all a scripture coming out of Matthew 5. And it says, now when Jesus saw the crowds, he went up on a mountainside and sat down. His disciples came to him and he began to teach them. And here we start the Beatitudes. He said, blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who persecuted you because of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people insult you, persecute you, and falsely say all kinds of evil against you because of me. Rejoice and be glad, because great is your reward in heaven. For in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you. You know, God has blessed us. And you know, as we journey through life, you know what one thing I've realized? We can say a lot of things, but unless we truly believe what we say, there will never be an outer expression. I want you to kind of chew on something. You're never going to have what you're saying until you inwardly believe it spiritually. If God says you're healed and you say it, but you don't believe it on the inside, you'll never be healed. Because on the inside, God's already done your miracle. But outwardly, you have to believe it. You can say all day long that you're prayed up and ready to go. But outwardly, if you're not expressing it, you truly don't believe you're prayed up and ready to go. You don't. And I know the difference. If you believe you're in, if you're saying you're healed, but you're still giving everybody your sad story, you truly don't believe that you're healed. God says you're blessed coming in and you're blessed going out. But unless you grab it, you can't have it. So today I want you to really think about some things. I want you to really meditate on some things that you've been believing God for and ask yourself, do I truly believe that God has already done it for me? Because anything that you're believing for, God has already done it for you. You have to grab it and you have to believe He can do it. No matter what. No matter what the circumstances look on the outside, you truly have to believe that God can, God will, God has. Amen? Change not only your speaking, but change the inside of you to where your believing is not only speaking on the outside, but your believing is a knowing on the inside. Amen? God can do it. God can do it. God has done it. Amen? But it's time to receive it and grab it. Amen? Amen. Pastor Mark.
Praise the Lord. And what are we supposed to do now? I mean, you just preached the house down. Thank you, Jesus. Tag team. Amen. What a blessing. I vote Pastor Kim as pastor of the world. Of the world. I just say that. You're the greatest pastor among pastors. Praise the Lord. Whew, when I grow up, I want to be just like you, Miss Kim. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Let's stand, amen. Let's stand. We're going to be reading some scriptures, titled them as foundational scriptures. Not necessarily a specific text in the Bible, but it's verses that we are going to use today that are going to help us with the message for the next 25 minutes. I want us to know during this teaching that we have an adversary. His name is the devil. Also referred to as Satan, which is the accuser of the brethren. This enemy has devices. He has tricks, strategies, schemes, and ways to twist the truth. Matthew 24, verse 4, as we've been studying about end time prophecy, Jesus Christ himself said to his disciples, because they asked the question. They said, when and what? And Christ focused on what they ought to be looking for. And the first thing he tells them, take heed that no one deceives you. Our next verse is found in Corinthians. The Apostle Paul is speaking to this church of Corinth, a church that at once was great, but then had some flesh issues. Had some carnal issues. Brother fighting against brother. Not talking about blood brothers. Talking about church member against church member. They began to build a fence because so-and-so was doing this and I should be doing that. They began to look with an evil, prideful eye, and envy began to sink in. Were they men of faith, men of prayer? Yeah, absolutely. But their heart was growing cold. So the apostle then says to them, while they're in the midst of all this mess, he says, don't be ignorant. Come on. He says, lest Satan should take advantage of us, we are not ignorant of his devices. Satan was taking full advantage of the brethren, accusing the brethren, falsely giving, introducing, and bringing them to a place where they shouldn't be. He said, don't be ignorant. Our next verse is found in Ephesians. Paul again is speaking to this church, Ephesus, and he's telling them that the enemy not only has devices that we shouldn't be ignorant of, but he also says of this word called wiles. Wednesday, if you were here, we defined that word wiles as his craftiness, his smarts, his cunningness. Put on the whole armor of God that you may be able to stand against. Someone say against. Against Satan's wiles, because he's out to trick us. He's out to deceive us. My last verse, found in 1 Peter 5:8, says, be sober, be vigilant, because the adversary, the devil, walks about like, someone say like, imitating, we could put there, a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour. Father, this is your word. Speak to us. Change us in the name of Jesus. And everyone said amen. Amen. Tell your neighbor, get ready. Praise the Lord. Come on, sit down and have your seat. Thank you, Jesus. I quickly want to just read that last scripture again. Be sober and be vigilant. When we hear the word sober, what are we thinking about? Be of right mind. Come on. Huh? I'm not here to talk about your past or my past or anything like that. But many of us, if I ask the people to show some hands, and I don't want you to do that. But if I were to ask you, how many of you have ever been drunk before with Budweiser? Oh, you said Budweiser at church. Come on. You've been drunk before, naturally. You were not what? Sober. You were not of your right mind. Sometimes maybe your past in that junk made you do some things that you shouldn't do. Come on. Some of you have had marriages destroyed because of it. Some of you have had children destructed because of it. Come on. Some of you have lost jobs because of it. Come on. Because you're not in your right mind. Some of you know people that are in prison today because of a mistake, because of an unsobering thought, because of an action that was taking place due to being drunk. Right? But Peter, the apostle, is telling people, be of right mind. Be sober. Think the way Jesus would think. Don't indulge yourself in a thing that's going to take over. Come on, somebody. Because what I do know is that when we have an intoxicated person, they have no control. I don't expect to hear a lot of amens, but maybe some past drunkards would probably know that's the truth. Now listen, church, don't get all starchy with me. This church is a hospital. We're not a place with perfect, polished policemen. Come on, or seeing everything you do right or wrong. Come on. We're a hospital for the sick. The good news is, where there is sickness, there is an answer. Come on, somebody. And his name is Jesus. And he's here. Hallelujah. His spirit is here. So don't get all starchy with me, all right? Been in ministry a long time. And I've seen starch when it comes. Hallelujah. And I just, what do I do when I see starch? I just shake the flakes away. What do you mean, Pastor? Yeah, flaky people? We gonna use this. Come on, somebody. Come on. I like starch shirts. I use starch my own slacks. Lord, thank you, Jesus. I like that crease. We're so lined up. I don't like double lines. When I get a double line, I throw them back in the washer. I'm not going to wear a double line jean. I like one line, praise the Lord. I walk one line, come on, not double line. Come on, somebody. I can just go crazy on that. But anyways, I've seen people walk out starched all like this, man. Like they're bored, you know, just praise the Lord. Do some bends and unleash, hallelujah. He said, be sober, be of one mind. And then he uses the word, be what? Tell me what that word means. What does that word mean, vigilant? Huh? Huh? Yeah. You are on guard. Come on, somebody. You are watching. Come on. You are aware. Come on. You know you're surrounded. Come on, somebody. You know. You are vigilant. You are ready. Come on, someone say, I'm ready. Yeah. You're vigilant. You're ready. You're of one mind. Because why are we to be of one mind and why are we to be ready? Because there is your adversary. Uh-oh, come on. He makes it very personal. And he says to the person or to the church that there is an evil presence that wants you down. He is an adversary. He says, your adversary, the devil. It gives a clear definition of who the devil is. I've met people to tell me, Lewis, no, there's no such thing as a devil. No, there's no real devil. He's just a red guy with a pitchfork and two little horns. No, he just comes out on Halloween night. No. You need to read your Bible. Because he's not a little red boy with pick or horns or a little whitey tidies. He's not that. He's an adversary. And he walks. Oh, he's not staying put. Come on, somebody. He's walking like the Bible doesn't say he is. Because the only line we know is the line of the tribe of Judah. Come on, somebody. This is like, it's an imitation. It's not the real deal, but it's like. And in the last days, people will see and hear and be deceived because they will not know. Because they are not what? Sober. They're not of one mind. And because they are not ready. They're not vigilant. And I'm telling you, church, we're getting living faith ready. Come on. Hallelujah. We're sharpening iron. Hallelujah. Every time you walk by somebody out of here, cheese bus fly. Swing, swing, swing. Praise the Lord. Come on. Now, I like the Geographic Channel. Eloy has been staying with us off and on, of course, with Tiffany and all that good stuff. Praise the Lord. He walks in and goes, again? Yeah, I like to watch nature. I like to see monkeys fly, woo, from tree to tree. I like to see, you know, cat world, and they get the little cats to the big cat. I just love Net Jewel. And I'm over there, and I'm seeing all of that. I love when they have a show on cats, I mean, or lions. Oh, I just love it. Man, I'm for it. Whew. It gets me all pumped up, praise the Lord. I start roaring in my house. Roar! You know. He's like a roaring lion. Now, I am not no geographic scientist, but what I see on TV is that when a lion is roaring, he is warning. When he gives out that, you know, how are they growl? Okay, so I won't be the only one being laughed at. I want you to, let's all roar on the count of three. One, two, three. Okay. Okay, enough. He's roaring because he is warning. The enemy warns us? Yes. Just like a rattlesnake. Before it ever strikes, what does it do? Come on. Because it saw you walking a mile away. Come on. It stuck out its tongue. It smelt you coming even before you knew it was there. Come on. The enemy knows exactly where we are. And the enemy gives warnings. Ooh. Or however a lion roars. I mean, even the lion vibrates the whole. What is the lion saying? If any of you dare come in my perimeter, I'll devour you. He's giving a warning. He's giving a warning. And some people, oh my goodness. Some people, it's kind of like watching, now we shouldn't watch scary movies, but when we were young, we watched a couple of scary movies. I'm free, hallelujah. And it's always like a lady or a girl. They walk into this dark house. What do you normally do when you walk into a dark house? Yeah, no, this little girl didn't turn on the light. She closes the door. Leave the door open! How many of you talk to your television? I do. Leave the door open. Turn on all the lights. What is that little cell phone light going to do? But she keeps on walking through each room. She closes every door. Oh, my. No plan of escape. No nothing. Not even looking behind her. Believe me, if I was in that dark house, had every light on, I'd be looking everywhere. I mean, I'd just be everything. Praise the Lord. But some people, even when the lion or the imitation of the lion is roaring and warning, some people walk right into the perimeter. And they're like, oh, I like what I see here. Let me get a little closer. Oh, what's that sound? Sounds so good. Come on. Well, all along that little snake is, and it is positioning. Come on, somebody. Every step you take, it gets higher. Come on, somebody. Every step you take, it gets more on focus. Come on, somebody. Every step you take, that lion is roaring even louder because he sees you coming his way. Okay, lo ya págalo. Mark, I saw Marky's face like, man, that's my dad in the morning. I mean, I'll tell you what, we get up like that, right, Mark? You have all the little lions. Then you hear Caleb. Aah. You hear Marky. Aah. You hear Bella Boo. Aah. You hear little Evan. Aah. You know, just squeaking away. Man, that was awesome. It made me shiver up here, man. We better be vigilant. Better be looking out. Man, some people walk into the perimeter of that roaring lion. Like I watched in Ned Geo Wild, those people are right there with the lionesses. I'm like, you're not Superman. Who do you think you are? And they walk into the perimeter of that lion. That lion is warning because that lion wants you. And that roar is actually an enticement. Come on, somebody. It's an enticement because we want to figure out where the roar is coming from. We want to figure out who's doing the roar. And we want to figure out if I'm bigger than the roar. Come on. When all along the enemy is doing his very best to warn you. Stay away. Stay away. Stay away. Stay away. Stay away. Stay away. Come on. The Bible says in Thessalonians, resist him and he shall flee. Resist means don't go in there and try to face up to him. Resist him says, I know you're there and I'm not going over there. Come on, somebody. If you're dealing with a habit in your life, you need to do your best to separate yourself from people that are in that same habit. But Pastor, then they'll think I'm a stuck-up Christian. Then they'll think I'm not, you know, I'm a holy roller. But Pastor, well, if you want to get free, you got to be set free. Amen. So sometimes you just got to do some things, even if it doesn't look appealing to your eyes. Some people walk into that roaring lion perimeter, and before you know it, you can't even see the mane on that lion because of that tall grass. Before you know it, you're so close and you're in his trumping, pouncing area that he gets you. And then all along, we Christians, we start blaming the devil. The devil made me do it. The devil did it. The devil. And the devil's over there and say, yep, I did it, but I warned you. Amen. And really what he's saying is you were, and I shouldn't use that word stupid, but you were blank to come close to me. You made the choice to step to my playground. But, and the reason why is because you weren't sober. The reason why, because you weren't ready. You weren't aware. You weren't looking around. That's why Peter began to tell the believers, he said, listen, he's like a roaring lion seeking whom he may devour. If the enemy who's defeated were to apply for a job, and they were to ask him, give me your resume. He would put three simple things, steal, kill, and destroy. Pretty easy. That's my job description here on earth. Steal, kill, and destroy. I love how the Bible does not end there, John 10:10. Part B says, or part two says, but Jesus has come to give us life. And life the more. Life in abundance. Amen. So we either choose whether we want to be stolen from. Oh, come on, somebody. We're going to be stolen from if we are non-sober. Come on. Come on. And let me say this. Being sober is not necessarily just being drunk. Being sober is being of right mind with the Lord. My first point, and we all need to see this, is that the enemy or the devil distracts us with things we need the least. things we need the least. I want you to hear that. The devil distracts us with things we need the least. It's one of his favorite ploys. He says, let them have faith. He says, let them cherish it in some corner. But don't let them pay attention to it. Come on. Miss Kim was talking about, let them talk all they want, but just don't let them believe it. Come on. Let them be an outer believer, where they can say things on the outside, but the fruit is nowhere displaying on the inside. He said, keep them busy with all these problems and all these pursuits. And with that, I want to go to a quick story found in the Bible in Luke 10, starting with verse 38. You know the story very well. It's a story of two ladies, Mary and Martha. And in this story, we're going to read very briefly on how the enemy can even distract us when we are serving Jesus. Pretty intense, church. I want us to go, please, in our Bibles to Luke 10, 38. Luke 10, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and then John. We're in Luke 10. When you're there, say, I'm there. Now it happened as they went that he entered a certain village, and a certain woman named Martha welcomed him into her house. Talking about the ministry of hospitality. Amen. The welcome committee. Come on, somebody. The greeters. Praise the Lord. Now it happened as when they went and entered the village, and a certain woman named Martha welcomed him into her house. And she had a sister called Mary, who also sat at Jesus' feet and heard his word. But Martha, verse 40, was distracted. Someone say distracted. The point I gave was the devil distracts us with things we need the least. The least. But Martha was distracted with much serving, and she approached him and said, Lord, do you not see or care that my sister has left me all alone to serve? Therefore, tell her to get up and serve. Tell her to help me. That's why I never get the attitude when I'm serving the Lord, I'm all alone. Nobody's helping me cut the grass. Nobody's helping me clean the church. Nobody's helping me with ministry outreach. Nope, I don't even step there. Because the devil will distract me. Come on, so you mean the pastor can get distracted? If the devil was in the wilderness facing Jesus to distract him, he'll distract anybody. But Martha was distracted with much serving, and she approached him and said, Lord, do you not care that my sister has left me to serve alone? Therefore, tell her to get up and help me serve. What was Martha doing? Well, she had a welcome party. Jesus and all his men were in a house. That's a big house, guys, I'm telling you. And she had a big refrigerator because to feed 12 hungry men, come on, somebody. She had to have a good stock on her pantry, praise the Lord. And so here she is, and I hear opening up the can. I mean, I hear the sartenes. You know, you ever heard mama with the sartenes in the morning? She's either cooking or she's washing dishes. Or dad, you know, sometimes dad, praise the Lord. And you hear the, I mean, you hear all the movement, all everything going on. And Jesus is speaking to the people. I think we've all been there before, where we're serving the Lord, and sometimes we make a little distraction over here to get some attention. You want the pastor or you want the brothers to see what's going on over here, because you really want to be over here with the brothers, the pastors, but there's a little commotion over here and you make a little distraction. I'm sure Martha made a little distraction while Jesus was teaching. I'm sure she wasn't that polite and kind of tippy-toed around the kitchen while Jesus was teaching. No. She didn't care what he was saying. All she had her mind was, why is my sister sitting down when I'm standing and I'm working? Come on, somebody. Why is my sister not doing absolutely nothing when I'm over here working? Come on. What? She ought to be over here. I should be there. I'm the oldest. Come on. You see, she was distracted. Martha. But Pastor, Jesus was in the house. Yep. But distraction was in the house also. Just like it may be distracting you right now too. Martha was doing her best to serve Jesus in ministry. But she got distracted. Come on. Mary was at the feet. The Bible says she was listening to every word Jesus said. Let's read on, and then we'll finish. What was my point? My point was that the enemy can distract us with things we need less. You don't need that. You don't need that. Oh, but you want that. But you don't need that. Oh, but you want that. Wait a minute. You're good already. You're okay with what you have. Oh, no, I want that because my neighbor got that, so I'm going to get that. Wait a minute, dude. You're not in competition. I mean, why? You're fine right here with this. You just stay faithful right here. I got one coming, and you're not going to have to pay for it. Come on. But you want to pay for it? Go for it. But I want it right now. Sometimes God doesn't allow things to open up because he wants to show you his blessings. But there's times where we want to be like Martha and get so distracted, we want to buy things ourselves because we want it now. It's my money, and I want it now. Come on. Heard that commercial before? But Martha was distracted with much serving. That's why I ask outreach leaders and people all around the world, be sober, be vigilant, use your discernment. Because even in your outreach, you'll become distracted. Jesus answered and said to her, Martha, Martha, uh-oh. Now, I have a loving family here. Mama and Daddy raised us well. Right, Lewis? They raised us well. And if I were in any way going to walk in disobedience, I would hear Mom or Dad call me not once, but they would say my full name. Marco Enrique de los Tablas Ayala Martinez de los Santos Ayala Linares. I mean, they just went off. Because that is what got my attention. If I heard Mark, Mark, I voy. Mark, todavía, I voy. I'm playing duck hunt. Back in the day. I'm going, I voy. But when I heard Marco Enrique, I mean, I began, you know, and she says, Lewis never did anything wrong. Praise the Lord. He still doesn't. He's a baby. Mama's favorite. I know that. Thank you, Jesus. He says, Martha, Martha. Martha, Martha. Let me get your attention. Stop being distracted. Martha, Martha. Come on, somebody. It's like somebody that wasn't sober and they're laid out because they fainted. You're going to say, hey, Javier, Javier, come on. Freddie, Freddie, come on. Get up, get up. You're going to want them to respond. Jesus is wanting a response out of distraction. And he says, Martha, Martha, you are worried and troubled about many things. You see, just one little distraction opens up a whole hurricane. That's happening on the inside. You might see it just like a little dust storm. Mm-mm. God sees the hurricane. Many things, but one thing is needed, and Mary has chosen that good part, which will not be taken away from her. Close your Bibles. I want you to hear that, church. Each of them, Martha and Mary, had a choice. It didn't say in the Bible that Jesus came into Martha's house and said, where's the feasting table? We'll sit here, go make and prepare dinner, and let's have it out by 6 p.m. I'm going to be here with the people teaching. No. They were in the streets, and Martha noticed some of the disciples were weary. She noticed that even Christ himself could use a little bit of shade and maybe some AC. And she opened up her house and said, bring your men and those whoever want to come in the house. And she opened up her house. Nobody told her to get out the china. Come on, somebody. Nobody told her to get out the barbecue. Nobody told her. But she wanted to do it. And because she did it, she got so busy, so distracted, she keyed and key-eyed on her sister, Mary. How dare you leave me alone over here? Well, number one, Martha, you're the one that welcomed everybody. It wasn't Mary. It was you. So here she is doing her thing while Mary's sitting at the feet of the Lord, hearing every word of the Lord. And then Martha comes and distracts the appointment. Not necessarily what Jesus Christ was telling the disciples, but Mary, the sister, wanted to distract her other sister from her divine appointment. That's why, siblings, be very mindful of how you treat your other sibling. Be very mindful how you react. Regardless if done right, done wrong, be very mindful. Because the enemy will distract you and you will become bitter and not better. That was a word for somebody. Shot like a bazooka. And I'm done, Miss Kim. Thank you, Jesus. I choose not to be distracted or deceived with the little things. Come on. The things that I don't necessarily need. I choose to keep my eyes on the Lord and hear every word he has. And if I head in some direction and I hear that roar, I know he's out there to kill, steal, and destroy. And I am smarter than him. He wants to entice me into his playground. I'm not playing with him. I'm going to keep my focus on the Lord. Come on. And I'm going to move with him in the name of Jesus. Come on, give the Lord a great hand clap. Thank you, Jesus. To God be the glory. Praise him. Come on up. We're going to get ready for an end song and just have a great, 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 great end to our Sunday service. Can I have an amen? Woo, today was on today. Thank you, Jesus. We learned so much today from the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. At every end of our service, we receive and lift an offering to the Lord. And so this being October, many of you bring your first fruits. You say, Lord, this is what you have blessed me with. And out of my obedience, I give my tenth to you as a first fruit offering. Before I do this or go here or celebrate here or go to this party here and buy a gift for this person here or before I go to pay this or pay that, Lord, I give you what is yours as a first fruit offering. Because I know you watch over what is yours. And Lord, on top of that, I'm blessed. I'm blessed. So I'm going to continue to give you, Lord, out of the goodness of my heart, because you said you love a cheerful giver, and I'm going to give beyond my tithe and give my offering to you. And then the Lord says, woo, here's the open windows. He pulls back the curtains. Come on, somebody. He calls angels because it's a big window. He says, get on that window, open it up. Come on, somebody. And they began to open up that window. And then I know the Jerusalem translation says, and then heaven tilts. Come on, somebody. And the window, the heaven is emptied out. Praise the Lord. And the windows are directed towards the giver, the tither, the believer. So Lord, you know our heart. You know where we are. And you know where we're going. So, Lord, I bless the seed right now in the name of Jesus. And everyone said amen. Nobody leave the building. Let's all stay as one family. Let's stand. Let's give. Let's say thank you, Jesus.
The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. In times of trouble, He will keep me safe in His dwelling. He will set me high upon a rock, a rock. Yeah, yeah. Be exalted high above my enemy. I will shout for joy.
Say hallelujah. This is a day you've made. We choose to always be in your word. Your word says and instructs us to give. So it'll be given back to us, Lord. Good measure pressed down, shaken together. So tithers, we tithe and we give. For we know the blessing of the Lord is on the obedience. Givers, we know to give because we know the overflow is on our cheerfulness. Our acts to love you with our offerings. So Lord, let this fruit, first fruits, be given to you with our whole heart. I call it blessed in the name of Jesus. And everyone said amen. What a blessing. Come on, let's give the Lord a great hand clap. Thank you, Jesus. I've had our greeters pass this out to you. It's our prayer cards. If you'd like to leave them here, then you can come put them on the pulpit or give it to us later. But I want to ask you to prayerfully consider of putting, you know, just something down on this, whether it's a need or maybe a family member that you have, you want us to pray. As you can see, we've had multiple thousands throughout the years. And this was the month of September, praise the Lord, and it's going to grow and more in the name of Jesus. So if that's you and you want to give us a prayer card so we can come in agreement, then do that after service. If you need personal prayer, we'll be here to pray with you personally if you need prayer. Amen. Let me bless you as you start your week. Lord, I declare the blessing among every individual here and even on those that are watching around the world with our media outreach. Lord, the word says in Numbers that you have blessed us, that you have said your face to be upon us. You said that your grace would live through us and that we would continue to walk like you. So may the Lord bless thee and may the Lord keep thee. And may the Lord's grace and face shine upon thee. And may you walk in his peace today. In the name of Jesus. Tell your neighbor, I call you blessed. Say, blessed coming in. Say, blessed going out. Say, I'm the head and not the tail. To God be the glory. Amen. We love you. See you Wednesday, 7 o'clock.
Salvation, whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. No, I will not fear. In times of trouble, he will keep me safe in his
way. Father,
he will set me high.
You are the God that heals. Who I declare that he's up and healed.
Over
him.
Joy
and I speak to him to my Lord.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Let people shout. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Let people
step that I take, every move.